Hi, I'm Kyle Miller, Enterprise Solutions Engineer at DJI. You may remember that I talked about RTK in a previous episode as a key to positional accuracy. For drones, whether RTK devices are equipped is also a key consideration for whether it can be applied to survey work. For example, the following aircraft of DJI are equipped with RTK devices, which can be applied to different surveying and mapping scenarios depending on the sensors they carry. Among them, the Mavic 3 Enterprise is DJI's classic photogrammetry drone, which is compact, capable, and has many special functions specifically developed for aerial photogrammetry. The Mavic 3 Multispectral is equipped with a multispectral sensory array, which can produce multispectral images that are widely used in the agricultural field. And the last one is the DJI Matrice 300 RTK, the flagship aircraft of DJI industrial applications. Its biggest feature is that it can be equipped with different sensors to produce different data products. When equipped with the P1, the visible light 2D and 3D models are produced are much like the Phantom 4 RTK or Mavic 3 Enterprise. When equipped with the L1, the LiDAR data can be produced for engineering surveys and high-precision topographical surveys. Although both are applied to aerial photogrammetry, the main differences between the Mavic 3 Enterprise and the Matrice 300 are in terms of weight, size, battery life, functions, and of course, overall price. In general, the Mavic 3 Enterprise is more compact and more lean. It's not only more portable, but has a wider space in the drone laws in some countries. And as a drone specifically designed for surveying and mapping industry, the Mavic 3 Enterprise has many features suitable for various surveying and mapping scenarios that current consumer Mavic 3 does not. All Enterprise products, including the Mavic 3 Enterprise and the Matrice 300, utilize the DJI Pilot 2 for autonomous flight control. Some example features of the Mavic 3 Enterprise or the Matrice 300 and Pilot 2 are, first, mapping missions. This template helps automate capture of a job site. By tapping on a location in the satellite view, you can manipulate the polygon to capture the correct data. Tools are displayed on the right to be able to change the mission settings. But if a mapping mission doesn't fit your needs, try one of our other mission templates. Waypoint missions help capture specific locations on the site. This can also be valuable for vertical structure capture. Linear missions automatically generate the corresponding linear flight area and flight routes for corridor areas, much like rail and roadways. There's also the oblique capture mode, which can utilize gimbal control on each of these drones to capture oblique imagery during normal mission capture. The Mavic 3 Enterprise will capture gimbal forward, nadir, and gimbal backward imagery while executing a crosshatch style mission to help get all angles of the asset. The Matrice 300 and the P1, on the other hand, can utilize a three-axis gimbal control, which allows capture of all five angles in just one pass. Compared to the compactness and the convenience of the Mavic 3 Enterprise, the combination of the Matrice 300 RTK and the P1 with the overall longer battery life and the higher shooting efficiency really outcompetes the Mavic 3 Enterprise. For example, the P1 has a full-frame 45-megapixel sensor, which is 2.25 times more than the 20-megapixel sensor on the Mavic 3 Enterprise. In the case of capturing the same ground sampling distance and shooting the same size survey area, the overall flight distance and time captured with the Matrice 300 RTK and P1 is greatly reduced. And in addition, the Matrice 300 RTK is equipped with two RTK antenna, which helps give more orientation accuracy and is suitable for more complex operational environments where compass interference is common. So the overall P1 CMOS sensor size, 45 megapixel sensor, dual native ISO technology, center blade global shutter, and more help capture an overall better image quality. Of course, supporting these high performance hardware, a higher overall cost is needed. Therefore, it's very important to choose the right drone and the right payload that suits your need. To learn more about industry drones, please visit DJI's official website. And thanks for watching. Subscribe to our channel to learn more about commercial drone applications, best practices, and user stories. If you like this video or if you have any suggestions, make sure to drop a comment in the section below.